Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. In the last episode, we began the City in the Sky, which is our next dungeon, and then in this episode, we'll be continuing the City in the Sky. We left off in this room right here. When you see, there's two Dino Falls. How I do not enjoy them. Nobody enjoys fighting these things. They're so annoying. And there's two of them! Please tell me. He fell off the edge. Wonderful. Not complaining in the slightest. I love it when that happens. Yes, fall off the edge to your doom. Gosh, I despise Dinofalls. Them defeated, those gates will open. I think what you want to do, Clawshot up to these vines so you can get up there. Climb. And then Clawshot up to this ball thingy and pull it down. And that'll turn that air vent on. Then you want to grab one of the Okikos, doesn't matter which one. And right over to the air vent when it's turned on, so it can get you up to this door right here on the upper floor. Same concept in this room. Take an Okiko. Come here. And right over the air vent when it's turned on. And ride. You want to ride over here first. We do want to go through that gap. We'll do that in just a moment. And I love how he was sitting on the chest and now he's on thin air. Purple Rupee in that chest. You could use the claw shot to get back over there. I need a Nook. Can I use the claw shot to get back up there? Yes, I can. Okay. There's some way to lower that. Okay. There's a gate over there you can lower by claw shotting up to this one. And I think that chest just has a rupee in it, but we're gonna collect it anyway. I need an Okoko. Is there any down there? Don't see one. I need an Okoko. This is a problem. Crap, I think I'll have to go back out the room back in to get the Okoko to come back over here. Okay, there we go. There we goes. Nope. Turn, Link. Yeah, use this air vent to get up there. Grab this chest. Nope, like I said, thought it was a red rupee. Yeah, it is. Okay, alright. Good. Alright, now that we've got those chests right there, and see that Okoko is stuck to the wall. Okoko can defy gravity. It's weird. Didn't do it right. There we go. Ride this hole right here, and then... Oh crap, that turned off. Let me make it. Okay, good. Made it. You wanna get over to that opposite wall over there. And there's a way to turn this fan on. crap, I had to pull that ball right there. Sorry, I forgot about that. Stay on, stay on, stay on! Thank you. Let me pull that down. Turn that fan on, so we can get up to that little hole in the wall that's above it. Grab the chicken guy, please. Alrighty. And now we can use this air vent to get a little extra boost to get through this hole. Alright, you can let go after that, I think. We're good. Yes, good, good, good. Go through this door. And this is the room. This is the, another part of the room where we got that area where we got the map. This is just the rest of the room. Okay. I think what you want to do here is have this cocoa and then float over to that little platform right here. See, this is where we got the map. It's a little caged off area. Okay. Here in this room, you want to kind of be careful of the air gusts, because if you stay in them, they will blow you out those holes and it will put you at the beginning of the room again. So be careful about that. I lost my Okoko. Wonderful. Can I clash out? No. Stupid keys. Cowabunga! Yeah, I lost my Okoko, so I didn't really have a choice on that. Stupid keys. Alright, let's try this again without falling. Our goal is to get to that bottom door we saw in the overview animation. You see there's a door behind the gate right there, but we don't want to go over there quite yet. Fly over here when the air vent is not blowing so you don't get blown out. And then float over here. There we go. Now, I'm not sure, is this the mini-boss room? I don't think so. Maybe? Oh no, we're near the mini-boss room, but this isn't quite the mini-boss room. We need to pull this down. Can't do it because of the fan. Put your iron boots on it. Should be enough. To make the fan stop. And if you want to get any hearts or anything, break these pots for her, but then you want to lower yourself down. This is the mini boss room. This is the introduction of Airphalos. I think that's how you say it. It's flying Dinophos, basically. Now, personally, I find these things much easier to defeat than actual Dinophos. I don't know if that's just me, but... wait till his shield is a claw shot. You want to pull him down to you when he puts it in the front, and then it'll give you a chance to slice him some. Go back up in the air. I actually find the Aerophiles easier to fight than the actual Dynafoles, because they don't dodge as much, and it's easier, in my opinion. Like I said, don't know if that's me, or what, but... Alright, Clawshot it over to this target right here, and we can get the chest. That is the dungeon item. You got another Clawshot. No, you're holding a pair. They're the double Clawshots. Alright, so now we can latch onto any place, and then while hanging, we can latch onto something else. We're basically Spiderman. Alright. Double Clawshots. And I think you want to Clawshot over to the closest target, which would be probably this one. Go down some. And there... Okay, we want to get around so we can see. There's vines on the inside of that fan. We just got to get to the right angle so we can see them. Ah, there they are. And you can use these to get back up into this room. Alright, now that we have the dungeon item, we'll be able to traverse this big circular room a lot easier, in my opinion. Excuse me. Because as you can see, there are several Clawshot targets along the walls of this room. So... I'm gonna climb up this way. Oh! Let's not roll off the edge. Over here? No. Here, maybe? Can I get to this target? Yes. Dum-dum-dum-dum. Let me go. Do not chomp on me. I am not your lunch. Our goal is to get right up there and pull that ball thing. Getting up there is the most difficult part. I think I'm supposed to hold up just a minute there. Alright, It's this target right here, and you should be able to get over to the ball from there. I love how Overcoast Defy Gravity is just amazing. Like, can you teach me to do that? Alright. Lower yourself down to the door, because as soon as you get let go of this ball, the gate will shut again. Clawshot over to this target, and it should get you in. Alrighty. Now, this is the lower room of the room where you were in before, I think. Z-target these. And these things will fall, so you want to kind of clawshot as fast as you can. And this last one is fine, because there's a block beneath you. Open this, and I think this is the compass. Compass! Alright, got the compass. Oh, excuse me. Stop it, body. Alright, what should I do here? First things first, you wanna, take out the Dekubaba snakes that are hanging on the grates, because we need to use them, as you can imagine. Okay. Now that they're taken care of, we can clawshot from grate to grate to get over there. Now this is the underside of that bridge that didn't get knocked down, so basically using these grates to get over back over there. And then over to the vines. Up, 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 not over. Alright, and I think now we're gonna go back into the center room. Is there anything in that area over there? Can't remember. Wrong button. No, I didn't see anything. There are no chests or anything. So I guess we'll continue on. That chest right there, I don't know if we'll be getting it. It's a purple ruby. It's like right in front of the boss area thing. I think what you want to do now is there's a ball right there. I don't know if we can reach it from this area. No, we can't reach it from right here, but we will be pulling that. I think what you want to do now, flash it over to this target, and then over to this one to get back over to this door. Simpler way to get back over here. And we're going back out to the bridge that the dragon knocked down. Now, since he knocked it down, we can now use these pea hats to cross it with our double claw shots. Alright. Don't blow me off. Thank you. Okay, I think what you want to do now in here is now I think we want to go to the lower half of this room. So I'm going to jump down, and you'll have more targets that fall. You can claw shot. Get over here, and then you can let go. And you want to walk over here, claw shot over to this target. And then over to this target, and then over to these grates, because there is a chest over here that we want to grab. Alright, get rid of them serpents, grab this chest, which I think it's either rupees or bombs. Or arrows. Make me sound stupid. Okay, now over to this target. And then over to this grate. Hop. Is there anything? No. Choose in this room. What you wanna do? Go over to this grate. And then hop down. More dead kebab serpents we gotta get rid of. Alright. Now, Clawshot over to the target the second one was hanging on. Go down. And then use your second Clawshot to hit this crystal. And open the gate. Over to this target. Yeah, we're basically Spider-Man here. I find this so cool. Scale the wall so you can get over here. Alright. Two chests in this area, so we're gonna grab them before we go through that door. I saw you. Don't think I didn't. Bombs. Got explosives. Good, good. I'm almost filled up on bombs. Okay, there's one more chest. Buddy, I saw you. Why do you try to hide from me? I see everything. Okay, other chest in this area. I think to get over it, you wanna hop across right here. And it's right here at the end of the walkway. Alright. Hop back over, and don't fall like I just did. I can't believe I didn't die! Legit surprised I fell on the ledge there. I was totally expecting to fall into the void of clouds. Alright, now we can go through this door. Alright, and this is, we've met these guys before. The first time we dealt with them was in the forest temple, so this is not really a new enemy. It's a giant dig bob of things. Let me poke you! Okay. Need to get a bomb. Here! Enjoy! Alright, now that he's out of the way, there are a couple big bubble serpents we want to take care of. Now, why can't you fall off the edge to your death? Alright. Now that they're taken care of, think you want to Clawshot out to that. And then quickly before you fall up to these vines. carefully, because this is a very narrow thingy you have to walk across. I think best interest, get rid of that Dekababa serpent. Just shoot him and then he'll fall off the edge. Let's see if I can get this keys. Okay, I'll stop. I'm trying to shoot him from here because that's not working. You want to kind of be cautious about swinging your sword around this narrow pathway because it will make you fall off. That's why I was trying to shoot him with an arrow. His leg doesn't move much when he shoots an arrow, unlike swinging his sword. There's a Clawshot target right there, but before we do that, we want to kind of sidle over to this area. Don't knock me off, don't knock me off, don't knock me off, please. Please, 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 please. Please don't knock me off, please don't knock me off, please don't knock me off. Thank you. I appreciate that. Have an arrow. Grab this chest. And that's heart piece number one for this dungeon. Alright. Sidle back over here. Shot up there. Shot here. And move to the vines. So our goal is to clash up to that middle thing and drop down. But there is one more chest we want to get before we do that. It's right below us. See if I can make this without falling to my death. Alright. Now, to get back up there, we'll have to go out the room and come back in, because those targets that we used to clawshot across, we need them to come back, and they won't come back unless we exit the room and come back in. And we can't reach that target from here. So, easiest thing to do, just jump to your death. I love how he pulled out his sword as he was falling. I think once we get this room, we're almost at 30 minutes, so I think once we get past this room right here, we're going to be ending the episode off. Excuse my feminine gasp. But I'm just going to sidle across. Slidle. Okay. Bye bye. I don't want to die by your hand. I'm gonna walk carefully across. Wash up back up there. They're in the way, but I still got it. You can drop down. There's a dinopulse right there. Excuse me? Yeah. stupid lizard. Gosh. Alright, through the door. And this is where we're gonna pick up next time. Next time on The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, we'll be continuing the city in the sky, and like I said, this is a relatively, I don't know if I said this, but this is a relatively longer dungeon, so it, yeah, that's why it's taking a couple more episodes than usual. So we'll be continuing this next time. See you guys then.